Hey guys, it's yours truly, Kevin Grace. I'm in Inglewood Cemetery, and one of my favorite comedians is buried here, and I never had a chance to see where she's buried. Well, actually, behind me is just a wall of names and everything else. The body is down below. It's much cheaper. It's kind of like a crypt like over here, but it didn't have to pay for the marble, and they're located, it's a non-visitation area. So what they do is just put the names up on a wall. That's a lot cheaper. Person I'm talking about is LaWanda Page. That's her showbiz name. You may know her as Aunt Esther from Sanford and Son, you know, you fish eye fool. But her real name is Alberta Pale. And she's listed here on the wall, and she's buried below. So here at Inglewood Cemetery. So if you're ever here in Los Angeles, California, right down the street from LAX, come by and visit Alberta Pearl, aka LaWanda Page, aka Aunt Esther. Peace.
I'll get it. Oh no, just what I needed now. A wino and a rhino.
Watch it, sucker.
You know, we really don't have to take this. Now, let's go, Esther.
Esther? Riley? Esther Winfield. Riley King.
Hey, somebody got you all just stand there while BB's being attacked by Jaws.
You look terrific.
And you're just as beautiful as ever.
The poor man's going blind.
Hey, Pop, don't you understand? E.W., Esther Winfield. Aunt Esther is the woman that BB's been looking for. What?
Then what is the guy that stole her away from BB?
What's going on here? Woody, that man is BB King. Esther left him to marry you.
I stole Esther from BB King? Now, what does that tell you, huh?
Don't act crazy. It's only petty larceny. Woody, you got to get out of here. Because BB said in his book that he's going to get even with the guy who stole her away from him. So you better leave unless you're willing to stand up and fight for her.
Well, I'll see you later.
So you're the guy who stole Esther away from me.
You want her back?
What's your name?
Woodrow Anderson.
Should I give it to him now, BB?
I have waited a long time for this moment. Yeah, give it to him.
Oh, hit the deck!
Pay to the order of Woodrow Anderson.
Hey. Here you go, Mr. Anderson. And I think you're one lucky guy.
Thank you.
Hey, this is a check for $1,000. Wait a minute, I don't understand.
Pop, I think Mr. King just evened the score.
That's right. If it hadn't been for Woodrow, BB never would have left St. Louis.
You know, I think I would have been very happy with Esther, but I think I'm much more happier since I started singing the blues with Lucille. You know, and I want to thank you too, Fred.
Well, you can make mine out to cash.
But that's not what I had in mind.
Well, what'd you have in mind?
Well, I thought maybe I could buy one of your songs and record it.
Well, you never heard one of my songs.
It doesn't matter.
Yes, it does. Well, my songs stink.
Well, there must be something I can do.
There is. It'd be an honor if we could sing one of your songs.
All right. How about right now? Let's go over to the club, Lucifer and Jam.
All right.
And then maybe we can dedicate a number to Esther.
Okay. How about Mule Train?
Ladies and gentlemen, a lovely lady, wonderful and warm person, Miss LaWanda Page.
Casino last night. Man, you were so smashed. you took a slot machine by the arm and tried to smooth talk it into coming up to your room. That's all you've been winding up with lately. Lemon. Don't start pulling on my skirt either with them hot hunky hands. Again, I'll kick you so hard you'd be wearing your jockey shorts at half mast. Get a load of this day. Look at all these white faces could make a lady snowblind. What you laughing at, Milton Berle? With those buck teeth, you look like a chipmunk in heat. I heard what you said, Dom DeLuise. I don't want no jive from you, fatso. You look like the Pillsbury Doughboy with the monk. Don't you start nothing, George Burns, you old geezer. He's so antique, he keeps his waterbed filled with Geritol. Look at Don Rickles and Telly Savalas laughing. Lucky you and Kojak didn't sit next to each other. The NBC censor would have made you two baldies wear a Brazil on your head. What you laugh about, Ruth Buzzard? You ain't exactly a sex symbol, honey. You could stroll naked through a camp of lonely lumberjacks, and all you pick up would be splinters. And don't you go stamping your gums, Jack Klugman. Anybody who spends 5 years living with Tony Randall, man, I'd like to hear you explain that to Anita Bryant. Mr. Francis Albert Sinatra, you've always been posing and strutting. You're supposed to be a big man. Well, let me tell you something, Turkey. Honey, Wilt Chamberlain could slam dunk you and still have room to palm a watermelon. Footprints in the forecourt of the Chinese theater. So what's the big deal? Everybody figured someday you'd wind up in cement. Good night, everybody.